Discussion on INOCA, ischemia and no-obstructive coronary artery disease. INOCA is the acronym for ischemia and no-obstructive coronary artery disease. They have elevated risk for cardiovascular events like acute coronary syndrome and hospitalization for heart failure. Risk of development of heart failure with preserved ejection fraction is also higher in these subjects. Some of them have coronary microvascular dysfunction and evidence of inflammation. In spite of the absence of obstructive coronary arteries, they have a risk of repeated hospitalization and repeated coronary angiographies involving significant healthcare costs. In general, INOCA is more common in females. They tend to have coronary microvascular dysfunction, plaque erosion, and thrombus formation. They may have more extensive non-obstructive coronary artery disease and have associated hypertension and diabetes mellitus. Major adverse events are similar to those with obstructive coronary artery disease. The CORE 320 study was an observational study of INOCA defined with CT angiography and CT perfusion imaging. Invasive coronary angiography and single photon emission computed tomography were also performed. 381 symptomatic persons referred for invasive coronary angiography underwent CT angiography, rest adenosine stress CT perfusion, and rest stress SPECT prior to invasive coronary angiography. They were divided into three groups depending on CT angiography CT perfusion or invasive coronary angiography SPECT data. Group A had 50% or more coronary stenosis. Group B had no obstructive stenosis but ischemia, that is INOCA. Group C had no obstructive stenosis and normal perfusion imaging results. 31 of the 115 participants without obstructive coronary artery disease at CT angiography had abnormal CT perfusion studies. In those who had a combination of invasive coronary angiography and SPECT, 45 of the 151 without obstructive coronary artery disease had INOCA. Those with INOCA had greater atherosclerotic burden and more adverse plaque features on CT compared with those who had no obstructive stenosis and no ischemia. This would imply that treatment aimed at prevention of progression of atherosclerosis is needed in those with INOCA. An accompanying editorial mentioned that CT perfusion provides data on the presence of microvascular dysfunction in INOCA. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.